We have two carts on a physics track, rolling on a level track with negligible friction. They have small magnets in their ends so that when they collide, they stick together. All right, I'm going to start drawing a diagram here and say I have one cart, lovely cart, with its mass, M2, V2, and velocity, where we say that velocity is 1.33 meters per second. And then we have another cart that we'll call cart 1, M1, V1, that's rolling with some velocity of 0.75 meters per second. And I put 2 on the left because the first cart is rolling at 0.75, the second one is rolling at 1.33. So if they're rolling to the right as I've drawn them, and as it says there, then the second cart has to be behind the first cart for it to be able to catch up to the first cart. So that's our initial situation. And then our final situation is that the magnets are holding these carts together. So we have the cart and the other cart, and they're being held together by the magnets. And they have some combined mass, M1 plus M2, times the final velocity that I'll call VF. So this is my final situation. Let's see if we can figure out what that final velocity of the joined carts is. I recommend we use conservation of momentum. And don't be afraid to write it out in your solutions so that you keep track of where did this come from. Here I'll say my initial is equal to my final. Why can I do that? Because I need to be able to neglect external forces. We're saying negligible friction, so we can neglect our external forces. And we need to be able to say that the mass doesn't change, which it doesn't. So the forces between the cart exist, but those are internal to our system, so they're not going to matter here. We can then write my initial momentum is m2 v2 plus m1 v1 is equal to my final momentum, combination of those masses times v final. We have one unknown here, so we can divide both sides by m1 plus m2, that quantity, to get my final velocity in terms of stuff we know. m1 v1 plus m2 v2, all divided by the quantity m1 plus m2. We know all those things, we can plug them in. I'm going to rely on you to double check me on this, plugging those in yourself, and you should be able to show that my final velocity of the combined carts is 0.997 meters per second. That might be more precision than we really have, but that's what I have written down.